Before starts, we have 2 minutes. Once again, good morning for everyone. I want to congratulate you. Today is our final day. We start with a master class from the deputy competence manager for juniors, Kiselyova Svetlana Vladimirovna. She will talk about visual programming in KNIME. And she talk also about juniors skill competition. Then at 9:30 a.m., Anna Malinovskaya will tell you how to register for the Asia Skills competition, which we will be organized in July. Then after a coffee break, Olga Maruhina will continue to work with experts to assess the third module C. Svetlana will be assisted by the interpreter Irina. Irina, are you here? Ирина.
Да, доброе утро, я здесь. Меня доброе слышно?
Утро. Да, 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 все отлично.
То есть все, что говорит Светлана, я перевожу, правильно?
Да, все верно.
Окей.
Доброе утро.
Доброе утро.
Меня всем. Слышно, да, все хорошо?
Да.
Да, я вас слышу отлично.
Да, можете начинать, Светлана. Да? You can start.
Отлично. Доброе утро, коллеги. Рад вас приветствовать. Павел Анатольевич меня уже представил. Меня зовут Светлана Киселева, и я занимаюсь развитием и популяризацией компетенций среди юниоров, то есть это возрастная категория 14-16 лет. И сегодня я вас познакомлю с таким видом анализа данных, как визуальное программирование.
Okay, good morning. My name is Svetlana Kiselyova. I have been introduced already by Pavel. And the sphere of my responsibility, I'm dealing with juniors, and I'm talking about their competences in visual programming. I'm dealing with people from 14 to 16 years, and today we'll talk about the machine learning and programming. Светлана, можно предложение, и потом делайте паузу, чтобы я могла переводить, окей?
Да, отлично.
Давайте так.
Подскажите мне, пожалуйста, экран видно, все хорошо?
Экран видно, да, отлично.
Да. Итак, продолжим. Мы сегодня поговорим о визуальном программировании, которое позволяет описывать процессы в графическом виде. То есть не умеет...
We'll talk today about the visual programming that help us to describe the processes in graphical way, in graphical mode.
То есть очень полезно для тех визуального программирования, кто еще не знаком в совершенстве с кодом, и в этом случае подойдет как раз-таки такой инструмент, как платформа для анализа данных, это визуальное программирование.
Okay, for those who are not familiar with the coding, this visual programming can be very helpful. So this tool, a visual platform of visual programming, can be very useful and helpful for these people.
Итак, мы сегодня познакомимся с платформой для анализа данных, которая называется KNIME.
Today we'll talk about the platform for data processing, and the name of this platform is KNIME.
Здесь имеются два инструмента: платформа KNIME Analytic для с открытым исходным кодом для создания аналитических систем, и также сервер KNIME для производства науки о данных.
Okay, here you can see two types of this platform. Analytics, KNIME Analytics platform is the open source software for creating data science, and the second one is KNIME server.
Чем программное обеспечение KNIME может вам помочь?
So how can KNIME software help you?
То есть мы можем, первое, это собирать и формулировать данные из любого источника.
First of all, we can gather and then wrangle the data from any kind of source.
Извлекать полезную, ценную информацию из ваших данных, то есть строить модели и проводить визуальное программирование.
And we can extract data from your models. It means we can model and visualize. We can start the visual programming.
Также данная платформа поможет команде по анализу данных сосредоточиться на предоставлении бизнес-аналитики.
And also the team working with the data processing can focus on analytics, on business analytics.
Также данная платформа позволит, прошу прощения, позволит использовать данный продукт для своего бизнеса с помощью машинного обучения больших данных.
And you can use this tool for learning, for teaching your business using the big data analysis.
Приступим. Что же необходимо сделать для того, чтобы запустить платформу?
Okay, let's start. What shall we do in order to start the platform?
Необходимо пройти через три небольшие шага. Во-первых, это регистрация.
There are three steps. First step – registration.
Далее необходимо скачать платформу.
Next step is to download the platform KNIME.
И приступить к работе.
Это and then you have to start the activity, your work.
После загрузки, после того, как вы открыли вкладку загрузки, выбрали вариант установки, соответствующий вашей операционной системе,
after downloading and after choosing the suitable settings which correspond to your system,
вы должны принять и прочитать и принять политику конфиденциальности.
You have to go through and then to accept the policy of confidentiality.
И нажать кнопочку скачать.
And then you have to press this button download.
Идем далее.
Further steps. We go ahead.
После того, как вы скачали...
After downloading the platform.
Загрузили установщик или самораспаковывающийся архив.
So you platform this setter or the unpacking archive, self-extracting archive.
Запустите KNIME для запуска... платформы для анализа данных.
So you launch KNIME, you launch the platform for data processing.
Что вы можете здесь сделать?
What can you do here?
Во-первых, построить рабочий процесс.
First of all, you can build a workflow.
Также данная платформа содержит учебный материал.
And also this platform has the learning material.
Содержатся учебники, которые...
You can find here also the tutorials.
Также вы сможете посмотреть подробное видео с инструкциями на канале YouTube.
You can watch the video on YouTube channel as well with the tutorials and detailed instructions, how-to videos.
Кроме того, программный продукт содержит большую коллекцию примеров, которые вы можете разобрать для того, чтобы ознакомиться с платформой.
And apart from this, this software has a big collection of the examples, example workflows, and you can go through these examples to know how the platform operates.
Итак, давайте познакомимся с данной платформой.
Let's go through this platform. Let's get familiar with it.
На экране представлен интерфейс.
On the screen, you can see the interface KNIME.
Во-первых, в верхнем левом углу это обзор доступных рабочих процессов и групп рабочих процессов в активных рабочих пространствах KNIME. То есть это ваши личные проекты.
In the upper left hand corner, you can see the active workflows. These are your projects.
Также здесь же вы можете найти примеры, которые представлены платформой.
And you can also find here the examples of workflows that you can find on the platform.
Следующая вкладка содержит рекомендации.
Next tab has the recommended nodes.
Ниже идет репозиторий всех узлов, которые вы можете использовать в рабочем процессе.
Further, you can see the node repository that you can find in the workflows and use them in your workflows.
В правой части экрана вы можете найти описание текущего рабочего процесса или выбранного узла.
You can find the description of the current workflow or the node.
Внизу у нас представлена схема активного рабочего процесса.
At the bottom, you can see the chart of the active workflow.
И здесь вот мы видим в центре, это как раз-таки активный рабочий процесс.
And in the middle, you can see just the active workflow.
Плюс имеется консоль для отображения сведений по работе.
Plus you have this console in the bottom that reflects all the, you know, values and values about the activity, the operation of the workflow.
При работе, при построении рабочего процесса мы будем с вами использовать узлы.
While working, we'll use nodes.
В KNIME отдельные задачи представлены узлами. Каждый узел отображается в виде цветного блока.
You see the separate tasks represented in KNIME by nodes, and they are marked by these colored blocks.
Каждый узел содержит порты входа и выхода.
Every node has the input port and output port.
Узлы могут выполнять всевозможные функции, например, чтение, запись файлов, построение моделей, визуальный анализ, всевозможные узлы.
So, and the nodes can perform different tasks, like reading, visual analysis, the forming of the model, and so on.
Узел может находиться в четырех разных состояниях.
A node can be in four different statuses.
Статус узла отображается светофором.
And it is shown by the traffic lights, you see, by different colors here.
Итак, мы говорили о примерах.
We were talking about the examples.
Начать анализ можно с примеров и рабочих процессов, представленных платформой.
To start analysis, you can do it using the examples and, you know, examples that you can find on the working platform.
Здесь представлен широкий спектр функциональных возможностей, включая поиск, совместное использование, совместную работу в процессах рабочих.
So here you can find a lot of different features, including the joint work and different processes.
Чтобы получить доступ к серверу примеров, нужно развернуть примеры в KNIME Explorer.
So to have the access to the examples, to the example server, you have to enter KNIME Explorer.
В платформе вы можете установить всевозможные расширения.
You can also use here different types of extensions.
Расширение используется для того, если вы хотите добавить какие-то определенные возможности.
And you can use these extensions if you want to add some kind of features.
Чтобы установить расширение, необходимо выбрать файл в строке меню и затем установить расширение окна.
To install extensions, you have to choose the line in menu and then to install KNIME extensions.
Как выглядит рабочий процесс?
So this is how the workflow looks like.
Сегодня мы будем работать над данной задачей. Это известная задача по оттоку клиентов.
So this is well-known task. This about how to retain the customers.
Нам необходимо будет загрузить два набора данных в формате Excel.
We have to load two data sets in Excel format.
В формате Excel и в формате CSV.
In Excel format and in a system file.
Объединить эти наборы.
Then we have to unite to put together these two sets.
Обработать признаки.
To process the features, the attributes.
Разделить выборку на обучающую и тестовую для построения прогнозных моделей.
Then to divide selection for the testing mode and for the learning mode. Training mode.
Используем алгоритм дерева решений для построения модели.
Then we use the algorithm decision tree learner to build the model.
Далее сохраним эту модель.
Then we save the model.
Сделаем предсказание.
We make the prediction.
И визуализируем качество работы модели.
And then we visualize the quality of the operation of the model.
Итак, давайте запустим.
Let's launch KNIME.
На экране вы видите у меня как раз-таки платформу KNIME для анализа данных.
On the screen you can see KNIME platform for data processing and analysis.
Создадим новый рабочий процесс. Это можно сделать файл.
Let's create the new workflow. We can do it in this way. File first. New KNIME workflow.
Вводим название проекта.
We enter the name of the project.
У нас появилось пустое рабочее поле.
And here we have the empty workspace.
Необходимо в первую очередь загрузить данные, с которыми мы будем работать.
First of all, we have to load the data with which we're going to operate.
В нижней части экрана представлены узлы. Развернем.
In the bottom part of the screen, you can find the nodes. So we open them.
Развернем узел для вкладку для использования узлов для загрузки данных.
So let's use the node to export, to load data. To upload data.
Выберем узел, который нас интересует для загрузки файлов в CSV формате.
Let's choose the node that we are interested in to load the data in CSV format.
И для загрузки файла Excel.
And also Excel file for loading.
Правой клавишей мыши выбираем конфигурацию.
By the right click of the mouse, we choose configuration.
И указываем путь к набору данных.
And show the path to data sets.
Прошу прощения, минуточку.
Just a minute.
Загрузили набор данных, он тут же отобразился в нижней части экрана.
We uploaded the data set, and you can see this data set in the lower part of the screen.
Здесь вы можете установить разделитель, что это будет запятая, точка с запятой или какой-то другой разделитель.
There you can put the petitioner, what it will it's going to be, either a comma or dot comma, whatever.
Нажимаем кнопочку OK.
Then we press OK. Click OK button.
Обратите внимание, светофор под нашим узлом изменил цвет на желтый.
And please pay attention. You can see the light changed. It is now the yellow color after our device here on the screen.
Excel reader. Также настраиваем узел для загрузки файла Excel.
In the same way, we set the Excel file to load it first.
Как видим, отобразилась таблица с данными.
Now you can see the table with notes.
Идем далее. Теперь два набора данных.
Now we have two sets of data.
Нужно объединить. Используем для этого узел для объединения.
We have to unite them, and for this we use this node, join.
Вы можете найти узел join с помощью строки поиска.
You can find it in the search line, joiner.
Объединяем эти два набора данных.
So we unite these two data sets, we join them together.
И давайте настроим.
And let's perform the settings.
Минуточку.
Just a minute.
Выбираем, по какому полю будем объединять.
We select the field here, on what field we're going to join them.
Выбираем атрибут первой таблицы и второй таблицы.
Attributes for the first table and attributes for the second table.
Добавляем еще одно поле.
We add one more field.
И выбираем.
And then we select phone.
Телефон. Yes, все, phone. Мы все сделали.
We have done it.
Объединяем наборы данных.
And we join data sets.
Обратите внимание, цвет светофора поменялся на желтенький.
Again, pay attention. The color changed here. Now we have yellow color.
Чтобы запустить верхнюю часть меню,
to launch in the upper part of the menu,
выбираем запуск. Обратите внимание, у нас светофора стал зеленый.
We choose launch, and again the color changed. Now we have green.
Это говорит о том, что все отработало хорошо, и мы объединили наши данные.
It tells us that everything works properly and we have joined our data.
Чтобы просмотреть объединенную таблицу, мы можем...
To view the joined table, we can press here, we can click this button. So now you see the joined table.
Обратите внимание, все атрибуты у нас объединены.
All attributes are put together into this table.
Главной задачей целевой переменной является отток клиента.
So I remind our goal is to search to follow the retention of the clients, whether we retain them or they leave us.
Имеем дело с бинарной классификацией.
And we are using here the binary classification.
У нас два класса, класс 0 и класс 1.
So we have two classes, 0, 1, 0, 1.
К нулевому классу относятся клиенты, которые остались в компании.
So to zero we attribute the customers who stay within the company.
Класс 1 представляют клиенты, которые ушли из компании.
And as one, we mark the customers who leave the company.
Выборка является несбалансированной, потому что представители класса 1 гораздо меньше, чем представители класса 0.
So this is a non-balanced selection because you see the representatives of the class 1 is much less than the representatives of the class 0.
Мы можем обрабатывать данные, то есть заниматься очисткой данных.
We can process this data, we can clear this data.
Приводить данные к приемлемому формату.
We can also change the format to use the suitable format.
Обрабатывать категориальные признаки.
Then we can process categories or categorical attributes.
Фильтровать данные.
We can filter data.
И так далее.
And so on.
Добавим следующий узел.
Let's add the next node.
Настроим узел.
Let's make the adjustments of the node.
Выберем все поля.
First we select all fields.
Жмем кнопочку OK.
Press OK button.
Теперь Quick. Давайте выделим цветом те разным цветом представители разного класса, класс 0, класс 1.
Okay, now let's mark with different colors the representatives of class 0 and class 1.
Для этого нужно будет выбрать узел.
For this we have to choose the node. Color manager node.
Выбираем конфигурацию.
We click configuration.
И выбираем, по какому полю мы будем.
And then we select the field again, on what field we're going to operate.
Нас интересует целевая переменная.
We're interested in the targeted variable.
Выбираем, здесь можно выбрать схему.
Here we can choose the chart or the scheme.
Нажимаем OK.
And we click OK.
Минуту.
Just a minute.
Здесь представлены различные схемы, обратите внимание, которые here, вы можете использовать.
Here you can find different schemes, different charts that you can use.
Вот я выбрала по городам. Посмотрите, у меня...
So I made my selection according to the cities.
Принадлежащие к различным городам клиенты имеют различный цвет.
These are customers that we can find in different cities and they are marked by different colors.
Теперь нам необходимо разделить выборку на обучающую и тестовую.
Now we have to divide this selection on the testing and on the learning or teaching one.
Выбираем для этого узел.
We choose the node for this for partitioning.
Здесь необходимо указать, в каком процентном соотношении мы будем делить выборку.
And here we have choose the percentage. And what percentage we are going to divide our selection?
Обычно это 70 на 30 или 80 на 20.
Usually it is 70 to 30 or 80 to 20.
Нажимаем кнопочку ОК, мы выберем 70 на 30.
Again, we click ОК, and we choose 70 to 30.
Коллеги, извините, пожалуйста, минуту.
Dear colleagues, excuse me, please. I need just 1 minute.
Коллеги, прошу прощения, продолжаем.
So we continue, we go on with our presentation.
Следующий узел, который нам необходимо добавить, это...
So next note that we have to add is...
Это алгоритм, который мы будем использовать для построения моделей.
This is the algorithm that we're going to use to build our model.
Мы с вами будем использовать дерево решений.
We are going to use the tree of decision here, decision tree.
Находим необходимый узелок.
We are looking for the required node.
Помещаем на наш рабочий процесс.
And we place it in our workflow.
Поместили. Добавить, кстати, можно либо перетаскиванием.
We place it here. We either can just drag it here, or choosing, we can choose it here in the table.
Соединяем с предыдущим узлом.
We connect it with the previous node.
И определяем здесь класс. У нас класс отток клиента.
And we define the class column. Here we're looking for the customer's retention.
Нажимаем ОК.
And then we again click ОК button.
Модельку можем сохранить полученную.
We can save the model.
Для этого используем узел для сохранения моделей.
And for this we have to use the node for saving models.
И соединяем с предыдущим узлом.
And again, we connect it with the previous node.
После построения модели нам необходимо сделать предсказание.
After we build the model, we need to do the prediction.
Для построения предсказаний также будем использовать узел.
Again, for prediction, we are using a node. Decision tree predictor node.
Соединяем с нашей моделью.
Again, we connect it with, we join it with the previous model, with our model. Just a moment.
Необходимо учесть тот факт, что наша выборка является несбалансированной.
We just have to take into consideration that our fetched is not balanced one.
То есть клиентов с оттоком 0 намного больше, чем клиентов с оттоком 1.
It means that the customers with the flux 0 is much more than the customers marked by 1 in a 1 category.
Если вы хотите учесть этот факт, то вы можете ввести узел выборки равного размера в тестовом наборе.
If you want to take into account this fact, you can use the nodes of different, you know, different sizes in a test mode.
Мы с вами используем узел для предсказания.
So we use this predictor node.
Ранее мы разделили выборку в процентном соотношении 70 на 30.
As you remember, we divided our fetch to 70-30 in this percentage.
И перед тем, как запускать на реальных данных,
and before we test it on the real data, or launch it on the real data,
мы протестируем на отложенной выборке, то есть 30%.
We'll test it on our 30% fetch.
Добавленный узел.
We add the node.
Дает возможность выполнить предсказание.
Added node, we can perform the prediction.
Выполнить предсказание целевой переменной для на отложенной выборке.
Of the targeted variable on our selected fetch.
Далее нам необходимо визуализировать качество работы модели.
Then we need to visualize how our model operates.
Будем использовать ROC-AUK.
We'll use ROC-AUK. What is it?
Построим график ROC-кривой.
We'll build the chart of the curve, of the round curve.
Если вы помните, данная кривая используется как раз-таки для несбалансированных классов.
If you remember, this curve is used for the non-balanced classes.
Отображает зависимость истинно положительных классификаций от ложно положительных.
And it reflects the dependency of the false classifications and real classifications.
Чем больше площадь под данной кривой, тем выше качество модели.
The more is the space below this curve, then the quality of the model is higher.
Давайте соединим предсказания, полученные.
Our predictor with this node, ROC curved node.
И узел для построения ROC-кривой.
This is the node to build the ROC curve. ROC curve.
Давайте проанализируем, что мы сделали. Мы построили модель.
Now let's analyze what we have done. First of all, we built a model,
которая на 70% обучающей выборке обучалась,
which was trained on the 70% selection, on the 70% fetch.
Потом делала предсказания для оставшихся отложенных 30%.
Then we perform prediction for the remained 30%.
И сравнивала данные предсказания с реальными данными.
And we compared the data from the decision tree predictor with the real data.
В качестве метрики мы выбрали ROC-AUK.
And as a matrix, we have chosen ROC curve.
С помощью которой определим, сколько раз наша модель ошибалась.
With which we can define how many times our model was mistaken.
Также мы можем выбрать еще одну метрику.
We can use the other metrics as well.
Добавим узел.
First we add the node.
И также соединим с узлом предсказаний.
And again we connect it with the decision tree predictor node.
Давайте посмотрим, что у нас.
So let's see what we have in the long run.
секундочку. Необходимо запустить все узелки.
So we have to start to activate all these nodes.
Можно последовательно запускать каждый узел, можно выбрать последний.
You can do it one by one, or you can just select the final one, the last one.
И запустить все вместе.
And to launch them all together.
Итак, давайте еще раз посмотрим, что мы сделали.
Okay, let's have a look again what we have done.
We
загрузили
две выборки в формате Excel и формате CSV.
We loaded two sets of data in Excel format and CSV format.
Одна из выборок содержала информацию о клиенте.
One select had the information, the data about our customers.
Вторая по...
And the second one.
Информацию по тарифу, который он использовал.
The data about the tariffs that were used by the customers.
Целевой переменной является отток клиента.
The targeted variable is the outflow of the customers.
Данные первой и второй выборки являются информативными для построения моделей.
And the data from the first and second fetches are informative for the building of the model.
Далее мы объединили две выборки.
Then we joined two data sets.
Использовали в качестве объединения.
And to поля. Unite them, we used the fields.
Соответствующий номеру телефона абонента.
Which correspond to the phone number of the subscriber.
Далее преобразовали формат данных.
Then we configure the data format.
Поля у нас отток клиента и...
We have these two fields. This is the outflow of the customers.
Вот преобразовали в категориальный признак.
So we have transformed it according to the categorical attribute.
Далее использовали подсветку, подкраску.
Further on, we use different colors.
Чтобы разделить признаки между собой.
In order to divide the attributes between themselves.
Разделили выборку.
We partition this fetch.
Здесь мы можем менять. Мы
разделили. Here we can change it. Remember, we choose 70 to 30. We can change these parameters.
Пустим. Использовали дерево решений.
Then we apply the decision tree learner, this node.
Прошу прощения, минуточку.
Just a moment.
Вот. Все хорошо.
Okay.
Так, еще раз.
Everything works correctly. Everything is okay.
Да, здесь мы разделили, посмотрите, по целевой переменной отток клиента. То есть с классом 0 это синие, с классом 1 это красные.
So here we divided with our variables the outflow of the customers, and we choose two colors.
Можем посмотреть, что у нас получилось.
Red and blue, and you can see the result.
Как мы видим, синим
цветом. By blue we marked.
Синим цветом подкрашены клиенты, которые остались в компании, и красным те, которые ушли.
We mark the customers who are within the company, and by red we mark the customers who have left the company.
Даже не проводя разведочного анализа данных, можем сделать вывод о том, что выборка не сбалансированная.
Without performing the data analysis, we already can see that it is non-balanced fetch.
Здесь же мы видим, что данные содержат 3033 признака.
And here we see the data has 3,333 attributes.
И 21 атрибут.
21 attribute, and these are the features.
3,333
строки записи. Lines, yes, the rows here. We can find 3,333 rows and 21 attributes. These are the columns and rows.
Также мы видим, что данные представлены в числовом формате.
We also can see that all data are presented in the figure format, in the numeric format.
Кроме буквенного кода штата.
Apart from the letter code of the state.
Который мы преобразовали в категориальный признак.
That we have converted into the categorical attribute.
Можно добавить узлы для кодирования категориальных признаков. В этом случае, думаю, качество модели улучшится.
Then we can add some nodes to characterize our model, and I think the quality of the model would just improve by it.
Так, идем далее.
We proceed.
Использовали узел для построения модели машинного обучения с использованием дерева решений.
And we used the node to build our learning model with the usage of the decision tree node.
Здесь необходимо обязательно указать по какой целевой переменной, чтобы являться целевым классом.
Here you have stated the targeted variable. What is the targeted class?
А также понастраивать и посмотреть на качество модели гиперпараметры.
And then to perform the settings and to assess the quality of the model choosing hyperparameters.
Для дерева решений, если вы помните, гиперпараметрами являются...
For decision tree, as you remember, the hyperparameters are...
Это глубина дерева.
The depth of the tree.
Количество листов в ветви.
The number of the pages in the branches in the tree.
Максимальное количество признаков и так далее.
The maximum number of attributes and so on.
Идем далее.
We
мы
proceed.
Создали модель, и нам необходимо будет ее использовать для дальнейших предсказаний, поэтому ее необходимо сохранить.
So we have built the model, and we are going to use it for further predictions. It means we have to save the model.
Модель сохраняется во внутреннем формате.
And it can be saved in the internal format.
Необходимо указать путь.
And for this we have to state the route.
Мы с вами не указали путь, и модель сохранена в активном рабочем пространстве.
We haven't stated the route, and thus our model is saved in the active working space.
По умолчанию будет вот этот путь.
So by default that will be this route.
Но для построения сохранения модели вы можете использовать любой другой путь, выбрать необходимую директорию.
So, but to save the model, you can choose any other route, just choose the directory.
Построили модель, теперь необходимо выполнить предсказание на отложенной выборке.
So, we have formed the model, and now we have to perform the prediction on the selected fetch.
Давайте запустим.
Let's launch.
И построили рок-кривую.
And now we have ROC curve.
Также определили, что целевая переменная – это у нас отток клиента.
And we again we have defined that our targeted variable is the outflow of the customers.
Наибольший интерес для нас представляет класс 1, именно те клиенты, которые уйдут из компании.
Class 1 is the category that we are focused on. These are the customers that are going to leave the company.
Поэтому из всех полей мы выбираем предсказания именно этого класса.
So from all fields we select the predictions from this class. Of this class.
Внимание, attention.
Прошу прощения. Мы можем с вами посмотреть, обратите внимание, мы построили дерево решений, и мы можем визуально посмотреть.
You see, we have this decision tree, and here we can check, we can look.
Вот таким образом строится распределение, мы можем добавить.
So here you can see the distribution, we can add here.
Ветви, но нужно помнить.
Branches. But you have to remember.
Нужно помнить, что основная проблема машинного обучения – это переобучение или недообучение.
That the main problem of the machine learning is over-teaching, or it's not enough, not sufficient learning, not sufficient training.
Если ветвей будет достаточно много,
if we have a sufficient number of branches here,
то наша модель подстроится под решаемую задачу.
Then our model will adjust to our task.
И будет очень плохо выполнять прогноз на новых данных.
And will perform the prediction on the new data very poorly.
Построили RO-кривую, можно ее
Okay. Now we have the ROC curve and we can look at it.
Можем посмотреть дерево непосредственно.
We can also look at our decision tree.
Можем посмотреть в таком виде, посмотреть в виде круговых диаграмм.
We can either choose these round or circle diagrams, charts.
И тут как раз-таки используется цветовая схема, которую мы настроили ранее.
And again, here we use the same color scheme that we have set previously.
Давайте отобразим нашу RO-кривую.
Okay, let's see our ROC curve. Let's have a look at it.
Секунду. Должно
Just a moment.
Сейчас, секунду, пока строится кривая, давайте посмотрим на последний узелок.
While we are building the curve, let's look at our last node.
Здесь также мы делаем предсказание для целевой переменной.
Again, here we make the prediction for our targeted variable.
Используя эту метрику, у нас получаются несколько иные результаты.
So by applying this matrix, we get some other results.
Так. Почему-то у меня не отображается рукава. Хорошо, сейчас мы все-таки это сделаем. И в заключение хочу сказать, то есть такой способ для построения модели машинного обучения.
So, in conclusion, I want to say that this way to build the model of the machine learning
достаточно эффективен.
Is rather efficient.
Позволяет экономить время.
Allows you to save time.
Не требует знаний языков программирования.
does not require the knowledge of the programming languages
и строит достаточно точные модели
and can build rather precise models,
с помощью которых мы можем прогнозировать результат.
With the help of these models, we can predict the results, the outcomes.
На этом у меня все.
So that is all I want to say in my lecture.
Да, готова выслушать ваши вопросы.
And I'm ready to your questions. Ready to answer them. If you have any, please, you're welcome.
Презентацию привожу к материалам курса.
I'm going to attach this presentation to the materials of our classes.
Если вдруг возникнут вопросы, то я готова ответить.
And in case you're going to have any questions, I'm ready to answer them.
Коллеги, слушаю вас.
Dear colleagues, please, you're welcome. Your questions, comments, your notes.
Светлана, thank you very much for your presentation. Светлана, у меня вопрос.
I have a question, Светлана.
Можете рассказать про то, как может графики различные построить, да, то есть, к примеру, там, для разведочного анализа, да, то есть, там, либо статистику посчитать.
Can you show us how can we build different charts here, either to calculate some statistic, to perform some statistical analysis? Can you do it with the help of this platform? Do you have these tools here?
Да, к нам представляет достаточно мощный инструмент, и почему-то он у меня сегодня отказывается строить.
In KNIME tool, we can find, you see, rather powerful instruments for this, rather powerful tools, but unfortunately today I have some problems with the building these graphics, so with the building of these charts.
Тут достаточно много инструментов, да, для...
Here are rather many tools you can find here, a lot of tools.
Для визуализации данных, для построения разведочного анализа, для построения визуального анализа и также...
For data visualization, for the exploration analysis, for visual analysis and also for...
И также всевозможные, вот смотрите, для анализа данных, да?
Different types of analytics for data analysis.
И также всевозможные метрики для определения качества работы модели.
And also you can apply different metrics to assess the quality of the model operation, how it functions.
Плюс здесь достаточно много, достаточно богатая библиотека с примерами и...
Plus here you can find rather rich library with different types of examples.
И здесь тоже очень много примеров как раз-таки на визуальный анализ. И,
here you can find a lot of examples for visual analysis, for graphic analysis.
Ну, у меня вот на этом все.
So that is all, actually.
А вот интеграция с Python, вы говорили, что есть такая возможность.
Да, я говорю.
You mentioned there is a possibility to integrate it with a Python language, Python. Yeah? Can we do it, Python?
Да, мы можем подключить расширение.
We can add the extension here. Yes, we can do it.
Которое позволит... осуществить интеграцию и с Python, и с языком программирования R, то есть...
And that can allow us to perform the integration with Python and with the programming language Rs, or what was it?
И добиться более точных моделей и более точных предсказаний, то есть...
And to get very precise models, very accurate models and very accurate predictions. Thus we can do it.
Основные базовые инструменты, они уже установлены в платформе. Если вы хотите установить какие-то дополнительные, то нужно устанавливать расширение.
So the basic tools are already installed in the platform. If you want to add any kind of extensions, then you can do it. Just use these extensions, add some extensions here.
Светлана, а можно еще вопрос?
Да,
I have one more question, Светлана, it's Ольга.
Скажите, пожалуйста, Светлана, а вот эта платформа, она open source, да, то есть она бесплатная.
So this platform is a free, it's open source platform, okay?
Есть ли какие-то ограничения, ну, функциональности или еще что-то? Вот за счет чего она open source?
Why it is open source? Are there any kind of limitations here, any restrictions? Why can you use it as an open source? It's free platform, as far as I understand.
Ну вот основные базовые инструменты, да, здесь, к счастью, бесплатные, это очень радует.
You see here the basic tools are free, yeah, and we are very happy with this.
Ну если вы захотите увеличить, да, расширить свои возможности, то там какие-то все-таки моменты нужно будет пропачивать.
But if you want to, you know, expand your capabilities, then you have to pay for some additional features, for some additional tools or extensions that you're going to...
Внимание! Attention!
Прошу прощения.
Sorry.
Внимание! Attention! Пожарная тревога.
Светлана, thank you very much.
Да, прошу еще раз прощения. У меня...
Once again, I want to apologize. There is some interference.
Павел Анатольевич, если будут какие-то вопросы у экспертов или у участников, то я готова, там, может быть, конкретно по какому-то модулю, да, подготовить мастер-класс или еще что-то, то я с удовольствием в выходные могу.
Dear experts and dear participants, if you have any questions specifically for some module here, I'm ready to prepare the presentation, the specific presentation on your issue during the days off. Please, you're welcome.
Okay, Светлана, вы подключаетесь к телеграм-каналу. Я вам вышлю приглашение, и тогда там будут вопросы от участников.
Yes, Svetlana, you can find the questions from our participants in our Telegram channel. Just connect this channel and you'll find the questions there.
Хорошо, я готова ответить. Жду ваших вопросов, коллеги.
Okay, I'm ready to answer any kind of your questions, colleagues. Thank you.
Anna, thank you very much. Anna Malinovskaya here.
Yes.
I see. Good morning, Anna.
Good
Please
morning.
Tell us about competition in summer.
Okay. Svetlana, could you please stop sharing your screen so I could share mine? Svetlana, можете остановить демонстрацию экрана, чтобы я своим поделилась?
Да. Ну все, я тогда прощаюсь, коллеги, с вами. Всего доброго вам.
Всего спасибо. Доброго. Спасибо, Светлана.
So now I will share my screen. Can you see it? So dear colleagues, as far as you know, this training was not just a training. It was a part of preparation process to the further competition, online friendly skills game. And to participate in this skills game, you will need to go through a registration process. And now please be very attentive because we have here two options and they are different for different countries. So first of all, about the dates, the friendly skills game will go in July and August, and especially machine learning skills game will be held from the 5th to the 9th of July. Each country will be allowed one participant, one competitor, and one expert. And we have here the cutoff date, the age limit, no more than 25 years old. And now about the registration itself. So we have WorldSkills Asia member countries, and we have WorldSkills Asia non-members. So if your country is WorldSkills Asia member, you need to ask your technical delegate to register you through their website. Each technical delegate has his or her personal account on WorldSkills Asia website. You can see the link here, and I will share this presentation in our Telegram chat so you could save it. And you need just to ask your technical delegate to register you. Our colleagues from WorldSkills Asia also created a guideline how to register it. I will share this guideline in our Telegram chat either. So it's a really easy process. You just need to ask your technical delegate to help you. And now for non-member countries, if your country is not a member of WorldSkills Asia, you will need to use Excel form you will need to send this application as you did it before the training to my email. You can see it also on the presentation, and of course I will share it so you could save it. So you just fill in the form and send it to the email. Now save the registration deadline. It is the end of June. And of course, if you have any questions or comments, please share them in the Telegram chat and we will answer them. Please give me feedback if everything is clear. Should I repeat anything? Okay, I suppose everything is clear, but if you have any questions, please write them in the chat to the meeting or in our Telegram chat. Thank you.
Thank you, Anna. I hope that all school participants will participate in the championship in the summer. Now we have a coffee break, 15 minutes, and Olga, these experts, will start assessment module C. Yes, Olga, are you here?
Yes, we are going to start after the coffee break. I'm here, I'm ready to start, but after 15 minutes break. You are welcome after 15 minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Нет, нет. Dear colleagues, good day, good afternoon, good morning for all. It depends on your time zone, your countries. Today I have a nice spring day, sunny day, and I think we should start to continue our work today. Today, our last day of our training camp, and we should finish our assessment work. The situation we have today with our assessment. Now I share my screen and demonstrate to you. And demonstrate to you the situation with your answers, with results. According to our Google Classroom, I open module C, and now I have found only 5 results, but 1 hour again, it was 6. Where is one result? Result from place 49 participants, participant place 49. Has deleted his or her result and placed back it as soon as possible. And what I have found else? Module B. Yesterday we have found only 4 results, but during the night, during yesterday and during today morning, another 2 participants uploaded the results. It's place 49 and place 50, and so who is? It is 2 competitors from China, and dear experts. I uploaded the results into our folder module B, in the Google Drive, yes, and here you can find the results of from these participants, number 6 and number 7. And so I want to ask you to check these results and put your assessment into our table, assessment module B. We did it yesterday together with experts from Emirates and 2 experts from China. Unfortunately, only 3 experts took part into the assessment procedure. It's unfortunately it's very a bad situation. I hoped at least several experts, maybe not all, maybe 1, 2, or 3 experts from each country, would take part into this procedure. But unfortunately, today we have only results from my colleagues from China and Emirates, and I hope during our championship on July, we will work together and maybe more useful than now. And I hope maybe from other countries, another experts will put their marks into the table, our tables. Today, what we should do today? Today we should evaluate last module, module C, module about regression, and put our marks into this table. And now I want to share the folder C, folder with the results of C module, module C. Now I try to open access and send you link. And now I put I type the now I stop share the screen and I will continue it after I type the links. Just a moment. Results. Do you see? У меня вообще все зависло. Супер. Okay, they are all now. Today, I don't know why, but I have a technical problem with my computer. I don't know why, but sometimes it froze. But I can't understand what is it and what the situation. But please don't lose me. I will come back after I have my my computer will have a problem. I will come back after I solve this problem. Don't lose me. So I type the link to the result of module C. I typed it into our Telegram channel and chat room bot. Please find it and. I type the link to the table assessment. Just a moment, it needs me several seconds. So, I type the link to the table. And now I'm going to do it in the our Telegram channel. And my Telegram channel is false too. Okay. And the table assessment module C. Okay, now you have two links. First link it's two results of module C, and the second link to the table assessment. Please try to open both these links. Dear experts who will take part into the assessment procedure, please try to open this link and let me know if you have some problems, please. So now I try to switch on my camera and I hope will not problem with video traffic today. Because I don't know, maybe it's Friday and my computer decide to have a rest. I don't know why, but today I have some technical problems with the internet and this computer in general. So I hope we will work with you this session, this class without some problems. So let's start. Okay, now you have two links. Please try to open both of these links. And now I share my screen again. Dear colleagues, please let me know if you have some problems with links, if you can't open it on something else. Let me know, please. And dear experts who this information for that experts who's not with us now, please do your assessment later as soon as possible, please, during this day, because today we have a last day, and until Monday, and until Monday we need to summarize our marks and integrate the general marks and decide what the situation. But any case, I want to remind you that we have only training camp, so we will not rank our students. Yes, we talk only about some mistakes, some errors, maybe some I get you some notification, suggestion, and so on for your future successful participation into the our summer competition, into our summer competition. So but for general picture, for general situation, for understanding general situation, we need your answers, your feedback, your marks, and we should understand that all in all, procedure of assessment is easy for you, clear for you, and we have small problems with organization part in our summer camp, because in summer camp all experts will work and will do the assessment, will estimate the results. It is necessary for all experts, and we should understand that all our colleagues, all our experts have knowledge how to do it. So let's start to evaluate. I share my screen. Please, dear colleagues, if you don't watch my screen, let me know. And let's start. So I have a table, assessment module C, and what we shall evaluate in this module. Let's come back to Google Classroom and show the home task. This is a home task, and what our competitors should to do. First, this is regression recovery. Yes, it's task about regression. It's what is a regression? It's a forecasting, it's a prediction. Yes, it's a task of the goal of this main goal of the regression. It's a prediction, it's a forecast. So a forecasting. So what they should to do? First, selection of features, selection of features. So it is necessary to determine which characteristics have the greatest influence on real estate prices, median house value, and leave them only for training. So from this text, we should understand that target variable for our task, it's a median house value. Median house value. And we should analyze our features, our parameters, yes, and decide what parameters we should add to the model and what parameters we can exclude. All original signs may remain, and it's necessary to justify the choice of features left for the training. Dear colleagues, dear competitors, dear experts, any case, it's especially for the participants, for the competitors. Yes, please, during your work, during your solution, you should get a comments, you should get a conclusion, maybe your definition about your results in your report. Yes, for example, I decide to stay these parameters with feature in my model. Why? You should describe why. You should describe why you select these features or parameters, yes, or why you exclude these parameters from model. Why? It's randomly, maybe you use I do not join and understand, yes, what features, but you should describe for experts. Why you did it. Next, what they should to do, dividing the data into the training set and test set. Okay, it's a classic, very classic, yes, training and test samples. So it's a second task. It is necessary to determine the principle of dividing training and testing samples. Why? Sub-principle, yes. Why? Even if you choose to randomly split your data, you need to justify your choice of this principle. Okay, the same. You need, you should put the definition why you split the sample, for example, 80-20 or 70-30 or maybe 50-50 and why. What answers can be, for example, according to the famous literature, usually, and according to the my experience, yes, or maybe according to something, yet I has divided my sample into the training and testing samples, and next description why. So next, prediction. It is necessary to choose a model for forecasting real estimate prices, estate prices, median house value. Usually the choice of the model. It is necessary to train the model on a training set and test it. After testing, it is necessary to evaluate the accuracy of the selected model. Very classic task, very classic approach. And I know that Dmitry yesterday talked about how to do it. And they should build a report, according to these conditions. what about conditions? It's a special format, Jupyter notebook or the same, yes, similar. And the PDF or HTML format, what do you prefer? And it's okay, and it's enough. It's enough for module C. Okay, now we understand what you should to estimate and come back to our table. Here, on the first sheet, I put the information about some small statistics of results. Yes, the same name, the same participants. Unfortunately, our one participant, number five, maybe unfortunately, maybe fortunately, this participant was an expert. And now, Yasmin, 2 days she worked with me and we estimated together with her your results of our competitors. So this competitor now as an expert, she has only module A, and after that she started to work as an expert. And thank you very much, Yasmin, because we worked with you during the last 2 days. So what the aspects of module C? First, participant has selected the features using a sampling method. Participant has analyzed the impact of each feature using visualization. Three OMA machine learning methods have been analyzed for use as predictive models. The accuracy of the methods under review have been evaluated. Recall of the machine was the same, another the same as yesterday. And yesterday I commented with aspects, and now I have found that the aspects in general the same. And I think we start to do our assessment, to evaluate the results of our participants. So, model C, and first our participant, Jingwen Shi from China, so participant number one. I try to open his or she's result. First our aspect, the participant has selected the features using a sampling method. Dear experts, I want to remind you that usually in the championship, during the championship, all experts which are included into the assessment team work together, then they estimate the objective marks, objective aspects. Yes, what is objective aspects? I remind you that is a binary, there are two types of these aspects, binary and discrete. And in our assessment scheme, we have found that these aspects are objective. Why? Because we should put only two, we have only two ways for assessment. We should put only maximum number of points, one, or another way, zero, and nothing else. Only maximum or nothing. Only one in this case, yes, or zero. Only 2 points in this case for this aspect, or zero. And I remind you that we have also judgment aspects, and these aspects usually we evaluate with not cooperation personally, and put marks according to quality levels from 0 to 3. 0, it's nothing, it's very bad quality, it's a zero quality, yes, and 3, it's a god quality level, god level, and it's very, very excellent. It's it's perfect, very perfect, I don't know, it's a level god, and 1 or 2. So we have a description, what does it mean, 0, 1, 2, or 3. Remind you again, these marks we should put together, or one mark for the team. We cooperate, we discuss, yes, maybe maybe agree with another, maybe have a discussion, and so on. Find the truth, yes, and after that put one common mark, general for all colleagues from the assessment team. But here we have a personality approach, and all expert should put personal mark. Okay, difference between the marks should not greater than one point, because 1, 2, 2, 3, but it's not possible. One expert put one and another put 3. Yes, it's not possible. It's a bad situation. And in this situation, need to be solved. So, come back to the estimation. First, participant has selected the features using a sampling method. Dear colleague, maybe I'm not very careful, maybe it's my opinion, and here we put a personality mark for all competitors, for all aspects, and maybe I will have a mistake. Maybe it's my opinion, maybe I'm not careful and so on, because it's very important to be careful in the checking the reports and talking with you. So you should help me maybe now, maybe later, and put your marks according to your opinion, please. So come back. The participant has selected the features using the sampling methods. Just try to understand it. First, loading data, data team. Так. Selection the feature. Okay. Median house value. Mm-hmm. Median house value and another parameters, another features. We compare with median house value using the correlation, yes, and try to understand. Okay, and use and this participant used the visualization methods for understanding. I think yes. It's very interesting, dear colleagues, dear participants. I want to remind you that it's very useful approach. It's very maybe very interesting result. But why haven't some text? What does it mean? What I should to understand from your code, from your only values, without some conclusion, without some definitions. Could you please in future you get a maybe not for each, yes, but for main results, for main steps, you should put some text, some conclusions maybe. Just a moment. Mm-hmm. Some maybe words, outputs. What does it mean? What about it? And for example, why you build the histogram for what? For I don't know, for what result? For maybe next step? For data preparation, for selection of feature, for why, for what goal, and what the situation. You have built the histogram, and what outputs, what results, what your decision maybe, for what you have done it, and you built a correlation matrix, and for what, where is your result? This is right, this is true, but you should describe for us, for expert, for what, and what result do you have? It's very useful for experts and for understanding about your working, about maybe way of the solution, yes, and so on. Not very big text. Some words only, for what and what do you have and what your solution, what your maybe decision, what your description and so on. Next. Okay, according to this, I understand that this participant selected the features. So I put, just a moment, I put one for this aspect. Please, dear experts, please do the same. Please put your marks, and maybe you have yourself opinion, and it's will be great if you say us about it. It will be excellent. So next. Next, the participant has analyzed the impact of each features using visualization. Yes, we have found it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Three or more machine learning methods have been analyzed for using predictive models. I remind you that today we talk about regression, about the forecasting, regression, yes, and so we should find the discoveries about which are related with regression. And what three or more machine learning methods? Okay, I try to find first linear regression. Okay. Decision tree regressor, okay. Random forest regressor, okay. And decision tree regressor. Just a moment. Linear. Decision tree regressor, random forest. Model. Not large. It's a very short description and only a decision tree regressor model. Again, without some additional text, without some additional definition, it's very difficult to neural networks for. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's minimum three I have found. So I put one. But dear colleagues, dear experts, say to their competitors that you should put some conclusions and some text about results, about what he or she have to do, should do and have done. What about his or her results, their results, and what I should understand from this report. Okay, next. The accuracy of the methods has been evaluated. I have found that it was done. And in the conclusion, also in summary, the training score decision and gradient boosting very close to one, but the training score in random also very good. Yes, this participant has done it. I put 0.5. The recall of machine learning methods user review was assessed. Just a moment to try to understand.
Dear colleague, could you please help me to understand? I have found only curiosity and R-square. It's R-square for regression. And I suggest and put zero for all for this aspect. I think maybe it's machine learning method recall. Next, the model parameters were analyzed and the optimal value is selected. Mm-hmm. The participant, he or she did it, but without some output, without some results, only code, nothing else, nothing. I haven't found some description, some output, some I don't know definition, and so on. Only Python code, and very small heads. And all. Okay, dear participants, could you please in future during the competition, put the description and describe your results, some words for understanding what does it mean, and what you have a result and what. So. Okay, let's be two. It's raining. In training camp, we will not rank. Okay, let's let be two, and go next. The model has been training and tested. I have found that this participant did the additional discoveries. He or she built the models and after that found the outliers, delete the outliers, and after deleting, removing, he or she build the models again and compare the results. Yes, it's additional step. Maybe it's true, but it's depend on the situation, depend on the task. Firstly, we should find the outliers, missing data, anomalies, and so on. Work with these situations, yes, and only after this manipulation, build the model. Yes, it's a very classic approach, but all solution, all projects, all real situation are different, and so maybe sometimes we build model and analyze some anomalies, and after that build model again. Yes, I know this task, but usual very simple classic task. Firstly, we should work with anomalies and outliers, and after that build model and work with model. Okay, come back. The model has been trained and tested. Yes, of course, I found it. And I think all models have been trained and tested. Sorry. The classifier deliver more than yes. Report has been presented in the required format. Yes. Oi. The report describes the sequence of the project structured. It show us the structure of solution. Yes, I think yes. And the external appearance of the report. I think only contains software code. Software code, I think yes, because there are not some description, some conclusion, and that conclusion, what I have found, very short, and I think it's it needs two additional conclusions or decision. Okay, next. Next competitor, it's who is number two? Xia Zhang, you're welcome. And the same from first step. So loading data. So. These steps from previous modules, module A, and next, three of more machine learning methods. And where is the feature selection? I have found the correlation matrix. And what? It's a very beautiful picture, but I haven't found some description, some results, only dividing the process data into training set and test set. Oh, okay, sorry, I have found median house value and correlation. Yes, it will be better if you put, for example, before this step, next, I will provide the feature selection. Okay, small hit. And build the correlation, calculate the correlation and describe. And what feature do you add to the model and what feature you exclude from the model, and maybe something new features you will build on based on these features, and maybe something else. What's the next step? You have found the correlation, and what? I haven't found the next step, which are related with these results. So dividing the processed data into training and set sample, it's okay. And graphs, it's okay too. So very, very beautiful picture I have found. Very beautiful picture too, by what? Maybe I will find the answer to this question into the PDF file, okay. I try to open this file, PDF format. And maybe I have found answers here. Let's try to find. The same. And unfortunately, I haven't possibility to show the picture. I don't know why. But the text, the same. Okay. Yes, he or she have done it, but without some results. He or she tried to select the features using assembling methods. He or she tried to do it, but I haven't found where is a result. So, okay, I put one, but in real situation, the experts can put zero. The participant has analyzed the impact of each feature using visualization. Yes, using visualization, I have found some graphs. So three or more machine learning methods was described. Linear regression, random forest taking, I have found. Next, what else? Three or more. Linear regression, random forest, and decision tree regressor. Three models are there. Yes, I have found. So I put one. Oh, sorry. Not here. One. Accuracy. I have found some accuracy for all methods. Now I have conclusion selection models. Short results, the sample, so we choose it. Accuracy, it's very high level of accuracy. Be careful, please, because it's very strange for these data. Maybe are there some mistakes, but yes, I have found the accuracy. Here I put zero. The model parameters were analyzed and the optimal variant selected. Trained and tested. Predictive model. More than accuracy. Optimal selected. Okay, and here after this calculation, you should put the conclusion. I have found the best model parameters, and these parameters are, and what parameters, some small description. You provide the calculation, you have a result, but what about this result? What about this result? As expert, I can try to understand your code, but I cannot understand what in your mind. Yes, what do you think about this result? What your conclusion, your decision? So you should put your conclusion, small text about your results. Model parameters were analyzed. Model has been trained and tested, and more than 90. Report, and here one as the previous participant. Okay, number three. Sai Chen. It's very interesting approach. I think this participant uploaded the previous result about classification. I think in this report he or she used both approaches and classification and regression, and the experts, please find the result from my report, what you want. Yes. Okay, now we try to evaluate the classification from this report, and now we will evaluate the regression from the same report according to the name. Yes. Okay. Selected the features. Selected features. Where? Features have been analyzed and discretized. Okay, have been analyzed. Maybe, but I haven't found the discovery about the correlation between target variable and another variables. And where? Maybe I'm not carefully, but I put zero. Participant has analyzed the impact of each feature using visualization. I put zero too. Three or more machine learning methods were analyzed. Try to understand it for regression today, yes? First, the linear model, only trained decision tree regressor. Okay. And what else? And a very important notification that in your task was a question. You should choose three or more methods and describe why you apply these methods, why you choose these methods for classification, for regression, and for another type of tasks. Why these methods? Why? The wide spectrum of answers. For example, I have an experience to solve task using these methods, and I know that these methods get us high level of accuracy, for example. Another way, I read a literature and famous author of this literature or famous tutorial suggest us to choose these methods for these tasks. So you should describe why these methods, why. But now this situation, I try to find the answers to this question, and it's very difficult to me to understand what it's about. Just a moment. The wrong file, sorry. Okay. Mm-hmm. Sai Chen just submitted the wrong file. Sorry. Submitted it again. Okay. Now I come back to the what number of place? It's number three, yes. Number three, yes, and number of place, it's 43, and I have not found place number 43. Okay, now we stop checking this report, okay? And please, another time, you try to upload the, okay, place 44. Just a moment. Mm-hmm. It needs some manipulations. I should upload your files to my folder and upload new results to the Google Drive for another experts. Just it takes several minutes, 1 or 2 minutes. It's very fast. And dear participant, be free, be carefully, very carefully, because if you will have a mistake in the championship and upload false result from previous session, I don't know what yet, it will be mistake. And in a real championship, it's not possible to reload the result. So what the situation can be. You work during the session, you have a best results, yes, but for this session you will get a zero because you upload the wrong results, wrong report. Be careful, please, in real championship. So I go to materials, module C, and delete this result and plot this for all experts. So I have uploaded your results, and now we continue. I should upload results in another folder. I have several folders, special for demonstration. Just a moment. Okay, and here we should update, yes, okay. Regression. Okay, I have found the two results, yes, and try to understand what it's about. Checking that it is the same as the previous model. Selection of the feature. Okay. Selection of the feature. And where your decision, what feature you will add to the model and what feature you remove from your discovery, from your model. Where your decision, where this description. Yes, you have selected the features. You calculate the correlation between median house value and another features and another parameters, and what. What parameters you will stay for future discoveries, and what parameters you will remove. Or maybe you will add to your model some new parameters, I don't know, based on this, some integrative parameter, I don't know, and what. Yes, you have done it, but without some description, without some conclusions, and what I should think about it. Okay, let's put one, because for another participants we put one, the same situation, but unfortunately there are not some description about your results. What results and what does it mean? What does it mean for future steps? The participant has analyzed the impact of each feature using visualization. Of course, yes. I have found the visualization. Just a moment, chat. Так, and understand about graphs. About graphs. Okay, and and what graphs, what these graphs means? What I should understand from your graphs? For what type of analysis? For what you have built it? It's very interesting, but without some description again. Okay, but I have found this graph, so I put one, but it can be best if you put some description for what you built it. For example, now we try to understand the correlation between target variable and another variables, and demonstrate us your result. After that, we put, so according to my result, this feature I will add to the model because, and these features I will exclude from our future solution for the, from the model because and why. Two sentences or one sentence. So the accuracy of the model of the methods and reviews can be evaluated. Dear colleagues, I say only my opinion, and it is not true for all situations. Maybe you have your opinion, and if you have your opinion, please type it or say it. Accuracy of the method. Linear regression model, random forest model. For regression, okay, perfect. Decision tree regressor models, the optimal value selected. Removing outliers too, okay. and accuracy, about accuracy. Selection models linear show the best result of the test sample, so we choose it. Okay, I think it's it. Okay, I think accuracy, yes. Here, for all zero, I suggest put here for all zero. The model parameters were analyzed and the optimal value selected. I have found that he or she tried to analyze the parameters, yes, the optimal value selected, but unfortunately, without some description, some conclusions, without nothing, only text and only results, and what? And what? And dear colleagues, here I put two as for previous participant, but I want to remind you, in real situation, it can be zero because we haven't found some definition, some conclusion, some outputs. What does it mean? only code and all. And what does it mean for future discovery, for future steps? What does it mean? What parameters you added to your model, and what parameters you excluded from your code, from your report? It's not clear. Unfortunately, it's not clear. Next, the model has been trained and tested. You couldn't find my homework because, I read chat. This is task is C, but you read in C3. Так, стоп, why C3? Okay, yes, C3. And you couldn't find my homework because the homework of module C today was put into day 3. Agent, homework module C, day 3. Yes, but this is from day 3. Not. I update this file and I have found new files. And I think it's this file, or maybe I can't understand you. What's it about? This is task is C4. Why C4? Module C. It's a module number 3. We haven't fourth part. Only 3 days and 3 parts, 3 modules. Okay, and come back. Module C, regression recovery, and the competitor 44, place 44. I have found these files, this result. I downloaded it and share these results into the our folder Module C for all. And I have found that this report is about regression. Okay, the model has been trained and tested. Come back. If this model is... we couldn't find... It was put into the day 3. Just a moment, I try to understand what the situation, because I think I have found the true result. Come back to the Google Classroom. And day number 3. Day number 3, yes. I open it and go to the show the tasks. Посмотреть задание, show tasks. And here I have found place 44. Place 44, it's a Sai Chen. Yes, Sai Chen. I open this folder and have found this result. Okay, and now we talk about this. I downloaded this file. 33. Okay, now just a moment. Oh, sorry, just a moment. Sorry, 33. Just a moment, I check. I check it. Thank you very much. I understand. It's my mistake. Yes. And I put into this folder, into folder 43, results of participants 44. It's my bad. Now I correct it. Just a moment, takes me some minutes. It's very fast. I close and I download. Correct result. Thank you very much for your notification. Okay, now I am going to upload this result into this folder. For all experts. Mm-hmm. And now I upload this result into my folder. Okay, I'm ready to continue. Thank you for notification. And maybe I'm not so carefully because it's very important to provide the class, provide the lecture, and it's my bad, I'm sorry. So let's go. Okay, now I hope it's your result. Selection feature, third iteration. Okay, I think these marks, I copy it to participant number four, because we checked his or her result. Participant number four. So number three come back. And from first aspect, the participant has selected the features using a sample methods. Okay, come back to the report. Selected features. Selection features. But the my notification the same, my opinion the same. It's right approach, it's right way, it's absolutely right for the understanding about the correlation between relationship between parameters, but in your report you should put some summarizes about your results, some words about your results, what about this graph, yes, and according your discoveries, what features you should add to the model, what feature you should exclude from the model, and why. Delete features with missing values. Okay, removing highly correlated. Oh, removing highly correlated columns. You calculate the correlation. You build the graph. And I can found removing. Only calculation maybe I'm not carefully, but you heard about removing highly correlated columns. And I haven't found this step. Only graphs, only correlation, and what? And what with what features we are going to build the model again found. So, okay. Selected features using template methods. Okay, I put one point as previous guys, yes, but I hope you hear my notification, my opinion, yes, and you should solve this task, and it is need be clear for us what features we use for a building model and what feature we should exclude. The participant using visualization, yes, this participant used visualization, but the participant didn't analyze the impact of each features. Yes, he or she calculated this using correlation, but without some analysis. Okay, but I put one because he or she tried to do it, and I hope he or she hear me and will do it in your championship task, competition task. Three or more machine learning. Today I'm very loyalty because today I'm teacher, I'm trainer, but not an expert judge. Today I'm not a judge, and so I put maximum number of points for all. Okay, but please be carefully, very carefully into the real competition. So, three or more machine learning methods. Participant has analyzed the impact of each feature using the, maybe here, maybe I wasn't careful in previous. The participant has selected feature using sampling method. And what is about your result? What your result is about? What I can think about your result? And what? Median house value. Yes, this variable has some outliers. And what? Okay, then my opinion is the same. Linear regression model, random forest model, and what else? Decision tree regressor. Okay. Let be true. The accuracy. I have found accuracy. Very strange accuracy. Here maybe linear regressor model. It's very high level. It needs maybe to be more careful to understand why your level of accuracy is so high. I think strain and test in both samples very high level, and here it's a highest level. 100% the predictive model is more than And in this part, you calculate accuracy of the methods has been evaluated, yes, and what does it mean? If you compare all methods, what model are better? Yes, you calculate it, and what? Okay, accuracy. Here, what you call for all, zero for all. The model parameters were analyzed, and just a moment, I try to find it. About model parameters. A model has been trained and tested. And yes, I have found this step, but without some description too. Okay. Let be too, but could you please put description in the future? Has been trained and tested more than has been presented. It's very strange that you have models with so high level of accuracy. It needs to understand what aspects it related. It's an additional step of discovery of your model. Usually if we have so high level, first our action, first our decision is to check, is it true or is it false? Okay. Okay, and here, 1, 2, participant number 4. The model has been trained and tested. We stopped on this stage and removing outliers, optimal decision tree models. I have nothing. I haven't some description about it. I haven't some clear results for me. And report. And here, 1, 2. Next number what? Number six. Number six, dear experts, pay attention that this competitor, upload only one file. This is a number. Stop. He or she updates the result, and I have found. Participant number 6, it's Queen Hua Zhang, and place number 49, yes, and here she upload 2 files, but I have downloaded only 1. So, GPNB, I download this file as GPNB for me. And another one, this is a PDF. Mm-hmm. So, and participant number next. Who is Jiahuan Tang, number seven. And here I can found. I have found two files. Okay, and I need to update this information here. Okay, I uploaded both files in our folder, and I need to upload these into the my folder. It takes me half of a minute. Okay, and number six. Okay, perfect. Both files are here. So we have a possibility to open GPNB file format and understand about results. So I remind you about first aspect. And the experts, I see that now estimate only me without you. And what about you? What about your estimation? Please get your marks into this table. Get your opinion. And now I continue to evaluate the participant number six. So, and first aspect, it's a participant has selected features. Duplicate feature selection, the same situation. They're all the same situation. I have found the hit feature selection and beautiful graphs and beautiful matrix, correlation matrix, but I haven't found some definition. I haven't found some outputs, some ideas. What about it? What about it result and for what have done it? For what next step? What features was selected and for future discovery, for future, for building future model, regression model. So, okay, as the previous participant, I put one because today I'm only trainer, yes, not expert, not teacher, only trainer, and I'm loyalty for all, today, only today. So the participants has analyzed the impact of each using visualization are real, in my opinion, not analyzed. I haven't some analysis about the impact of each feature to the target variable, only graphs and all. It's a not analysis, yes, it's only graphs. But I said again, I put one and I say my notification for future. And I think you hear me and you in summer camp, you will get your solution according to my notification. Three or more machine learning methods. Dear colleagues, you can put another marks. Maybe you are not so loyal as me. Please put your marks. You are free to do it. Linear regression, random forest, and decision tree, gradient boosting neural networks, five methods. Thank you very much. And I put one. But again, I said again, without analyzed. Yes, he or she used this method, applied them for solution, for building solution, but without something analysis. Why this method? Why this method better than another? Why this method we use for solution the regression task? Why? The accuracy and the competitors in a real championship and real situation for this aspect, you will get, can get 0 points. Neural network. And without some conclusion, what method is better? What the situation in general? Yes, only solution, only values, only code without some comments from you. So I have found some accuracy here. Model parameters were analyzed. I can't remember, are they analyzed or not? I think not. I think not. Trained and tested. This model has been trained and tested. Interesting result. On the test sample, one value of accuracy and test another, yes? Here, put one, more than I think. I think not. Here not. Has been presented, yes. But dear colleagues, it's very difficult situation for me because I know that the high level of accuracy, prediction accuracy, yes, high level more than 1990 it's this level, get this level, it's a so important task. Previous guys showed us this level, but my opinion, it's a strange result maybe, but this this model from this report demonstrate as the low, demonstrates as the low, maybe not low, middle level of accuracy. For example, neural network, yes, it's not neural network, only 63, it's close to 50, yes. But okay, let's be. Report describes the sequence, yes, of course. And here's the one. And we have last competitor, number seven. Dear participants, I remind you that we will not rank you. For all, thank you very much for your participation and your results. I think it is a rich experience for you and serious preparation for the summer championship. And all of you are, for me, excellent students. And I get you my notification, and I want to see you, all of you, in our competition. And I say again, thank you very much for your results. Without any rankings, today all of you are winners. Regression recovery from last participant, number seven. And who are you? Number seven, it's Jia Huan Teng. 50, number place 50. And what I can see. Feature selection, correlation matrix. Prediction. I will check the report in general, yes. How many linear regression, random decision tree regressor, and gradient boosting neural network. And the same notification as for previous, the same notification, the participant. And they put the same scores, number of scores for this analyzed as the previous. I think these parameters were not analyzed. Dear colleagues, it's only my opinion. Be free to get your own marks and have your own opinion. Так, ну, about accuracy. What I... I'm sorry, but for me, 0.05, and as for another people, another students, I put 1 point. So we have checked today, all of our competitors, I remind you, we have six results. Dear participants, thank you very much for your results, and I hope my notification can be useful for you, helpful for you for future work, for your experience, for your participation in our summer competition. Dear experts, please, could you please put your marks for module A, for module B, and for module C, because it's very important for us to know your opinion, to know about your level of points for each aspect. And dear colleagues, for me, it were a very interesting week, and I have interesting experience to work with you. And I think for me, it was helpful and useful. And I think during our next work in the summer, I hope we will work together again, and our competition will interesting. Will our work, our cooperate work, our cooperation, our future work will be interesting too, and useful and helpful. I ask you again, for experts, dear experts, be ready to work hard, work together with me in real time, not maybe with me, with another expert, but we will together in real time. It will be not possible to put your marks later. We will need to have a cooperation in real time. And be ready to put the assessment, to be ready to discussion, to hard work during 5th to 9th of July. So dear competitors, please be ready. Firstly, be carefully, be very, very carefully. You should to read carefully your task, understand what is about. If you have some question and maybe not clear for you, you will have 15 minutes to discuss it with your expert or with us. And first main rule, be careful, please be careful to read, to upload, and so on. First gold rule, be careful. So next suggestion, my suggestion for you, please get as much possible comments, conclusions for your results in your report in English, please, because you are from different countries, and in our camp, in our competition, we will use English language for communication, and your report should be built using this language, of course. And for experts, my decision, your report should be clear for experts. I solve this task and this description. I get these results description. I have chosen these methods. Why? I built the histogram, and this histogram shows us and what they show us. And I have selected the features, and these features I will add to the model. What features and why? And so on. It can be a report and this report can be clear for experts. Image that experts is employee and your future, I don't know, your customer, for example, and this for this person, your report should be clear. Okay, and for today, for this camp, I have all information and I finish my class, I finish my lecture. So if you have some questions, be free, ask me using microphone, using our Telegram channel or our chat. Thank you very much for collaboration, especially thanks for all experts who took part in the assessment. Colleagues, thank you. Thanks for your collaboration. So for all, I want to say bye-bye and see you. I hope see you in summer.
Olga, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I have finished.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I see. Now I want to say some words. Thanks to the participants and experts for their work at our school. I hope that all camp competitors will participate in the Asia Skills Championship this summer. I also hope that you will be able to organize competitions in your country using the documentations and task project that we have prepared for you at our camp. Ольга?
I switch on my microphone and you hear my speech, Елена.
Don't worry. I hope that you will organize your competitions in your country. And if you will have some questions about prepared documentations, please type our and we help you and help you prepare these documentations for your competitions. We have prepared some certificates for experts and camp participants, camp competitors. The certificates will be available via the link that Anna Malinowska sent it in the Telegram chat. Anna, are you here? I call now Anna and she will send it now. I congratulate everyone who worked with us all 5 days. Thank you. And I hope that you like this camp and you will participate all events that our organizer will organize in the future. If you have some questions, you can ask now or type in Telegram channel. Thank you very much. Yeah, guys. Yeah, colleagues.
Павел, can we switch off our meeting?
Yes, I think we do it.
Okay, dear colleagues, goodbye for all. And if you have some questions, please be free to type in our Telegram channel. Our Telegram channel is not closed and will not close in the future. So please we'll cooperate using this channel. Bye-bye.
Ирина, thank you very much. Thank you all interpreters who worked here.